students, welcome again in chemistry class. Today we will discuss about two topics. Number one, we will talk about condensation. Number two, we will talk about sublimation. So let's start with the first topic, that is condensation. Okay students, tell me one thing. If you hold a chilled glass of water in your hand, what happens after some time? The small water droplets, they just get collected, or you can say deposited, on the outer surface of the glass. From where this water comes? So this is nothing but this is condensation. How this is condensation? Let's understand. You know that what condensation is? Condensation is, it is the process of conversion of vapors into a liquid state. Normally, it happens when we cool it or we reduce the temperature. What condensation is? It is the process in which the vapor changes into liquid normally by cooling. Okay, so let's understand the phenomena that how condensation happens. So, it is what? It is the conversion of vapor to liquid. You know, in a case of vapor, the intermolecular spaces, they are, vapor means it is a gaseous state. You know, in gaseous state, the intermolecular spaces are large, and if intermolecular spaces are large, then intermolecular forces of attraction will be weak. Okay? So now, what happens when we cool it? Or you can say that the vapors, they come in contact with the cold surface. We cool it, or when they come in contact with, when these vapors come in contact with cold surface, then what happens? Means the temperature decreases. Temperature decreases. You know, with the decrease in temperature, what will happen? The direct relationship between temperature and kinetic energy. If temperature decreases, the kinetic energy of molecules, it will also decrease. When the kinetic energy of molecules decreases, it means the molecules, the motion of the molecules become slow. Motion becomes slow. When the motion becomes slow, the molecules, they just start forming the clusters. They just coming together. When the motion of the molecules becomes slow, they form a cluster. They form the cluster. They are just coming together. They form the cluster of molecules. When the cluster of molecules is forming, it means the molecules are coming together. Molecules are coming together means intermolecular spaces, they are coming together. It means intermolecular spaces decreases. When the intermolecular spaces decreases, molecules are near to each other, it means their intermolecular forces of attraction will become strong enough. When they become strong enough, they convert it into liquid state. Okay, in this way, the vapor is converted into a liquid state. Means the intermolecular spaces, when we cool it, the intermolecular spaces become less. Why? Because the decrease in temperature, kinetic energy also decreases. Motion becomes slow, motion of the molecules becomes slow, and the molecules are coming together. The cluster of molecules, when the molecules are near to each other, then intermolecular spaces will decrease and the intermolecular forces of attraction become strong and it is converted into liquid. In starting, I gave you the example of a chilled water, that why it happens so. So see here, this is a glass of chilled water. There is a ice in it. You have put some ice in it. Okay. And water. What happens? the molecules, the vapors from the surrounding. From the surrounding, there you know it's a humidity also. There are some water vapors also. When these vapors they come in contact with the cold surface of this glass. This is surface is cold. When the cold they come in contact with the cloth, this is the cold surface. What will happen? Temperature will decrease. With the decrease in temperature, the kinetic energy of molecules of vapors that from the atmosphere, it also decreases. With the decrease in kinetic energy, they are forming the clusters and intermolecular spaces decreases. Here intermolecular spaces decreases. With the decrease in intermolecular spaces, intermolecular forces of attraction becomes strong and it converts into liquid and they just form a droplets of water outside the surface of water. You can think many examples of condensation from your daily life situation. You know, in a very cold day, when it's a very chill day, cold day, what happens? There are glass windows at your home. You can see the glass windows. There are some fog that is deposited on the windows of glass. Why it happens? So it is also because of the condensation. You can also think of the windows of car also. When you travel in a cold day, what happens? The fog, the vapors from the atmosphere, they come in contact with the cold surface of the windows and they convert it into liquid state, means condensation is happening there. Now let's discuss next topic, that is sublimation. We have talked about in previous videos that whether the conversion of state, or you can say that the change of state from one state to another. I am talking about from solid to liquid. What happens there? Firstly, we convert the solid into liquid and then liquid into gaseous state. Think of the example of ice. Ice is a solid form. Firstly, ice, when we heat it, ice is converted into liquid. It becomes water. When we again heat it, that water, or you can say that liquid state, that is get converted into gaseous state. But there are some another examples. There are some special kind of substances. You can say that some special kind of solid substances, they get directly converted into gaseous state. They don't convert it into liquid form, but they directly convert it into gaseous state. That process is sublimation. You can think of the example from your home. Also, there is a naphthalene balls. You have seen in your home that we use a naphthalene balls, okay, to prevent our clothes from the insects and all. That naphthalene balls, they don't convert it into liquid state. They directly evaporate. After some time, you will notice that size of the naphthalene ball that becomes small. Naphthalene ball is solid. And after some time, or after few days or few months, you notice that size of it becomes decreased and without any liquid reside on it. It means that naphthalene ball, that solid, is directly converted into gaseous state. It get converted into gaseous. That is nothing but that is sublimation. So what sublimation is? It is the transition of a substance from solid to gaseous state without passing through the intermediate liquid state. So the process is sublimation, and the substances which undergoes a sublimation, we can also call it as sublime. So there are many examples of sublimes, like ammonium chloride, iodine, camphor, naphthalene balls. Okay, so we understand this also with the help of activity. So what in this activity we are going to do, we have taken, this is a tripod stand, I have taken a burner, and in the china dish I have taken some ammonium chloride, that is solid form. I have taken some ammonium chloride, okay. So on this ammonium chloride china dish I have just taken an inverted tube. Okay, I have taken some inverted and just close it with the help of cotton. This is solid. When I start heating, what will happen? happen? The solid that is converted into vapors. It directly converts into vapors and it just gets stuck on the outer lining of this inverted flask. It means the ammonium chloride is without coming in the liquid form, it directly converts it into its gaseous, or you can say its vapor form, and after some time it gets stuck on the this. Here you can see the two processes, and you can see that the solid is being converted into the solid form of this ammonium. It is converted into vapors without heating, that you know, that is sublimation. After some time, when you come in contact with this, means there are temperature difference, so it will vapors is again converted into solid. It is called desublimation. It is the inverse of sublimation. When solid is converted into vapors, that is called sublimation, and when the vapors directly converted into solid, it is called desublimation. There are many examples of it. You can also note down the some examples of the sublime are like ammonium chloride. This we have seen in the activity. Iodine, naphthalene, solid carbon dioxide, that is also known as dry ice. Now, what this solid carbon dioxide is and what dry ice is? Solid carbon dioxide, it is termed as dry ice because it appears as a ice. It directly converts it into, this is a solid form, it directly converts it into the vapor form, or you can say that it directly converts it into gaseous form. This is the dry ice, and when this solid carbon dioxide converts into vapor, means it is not converting into liquid, it is directly converting into the vapor form. This solid carbon dioxide, the temperature of it is very very less, and so that it is used in a refrigerants for the cooling, or for the where we use with the preservative foods we keep, there we can use a solid carbon dioxide for the very low temperature. Of the sublimes are, for example, camphor also. We use it in our home for the, you can say, the worship processes. And there we use the camphor, that is also sublime. We use the process of sublimation in case of the purification of substances. That we will do in the next.